So, I was just listening to a lecture series on World War I, the Great War. Widely forgotten because of what happened in World War II and the slaughter that occurred there. But this professor, doctor, lecturer, I guess would be the correct name for him. I'm unsure. I forget his name. Was going over memory, monuments, how we as a nation, as a people, go through our daily lives without taking notice of those monuments that are put up to honor those who sacrificed so much for us. Men gave up their lives so that we could live. Hard men gave us good times, and we take that for granted. We take it completely for granted. Our gallant dead, God, country, Notre Dame, in glory everlasting. At St. Mary's Basilica, a forgotten monument, a silent monument to World War I veterans who died for their country in a war across an ocean on a land that many of them probably never saw or never heard. But they signed up and they went and they died. And then decades later, their monument is not looked at as anything other than a doorway. That makes me sad. That makes me wonder, what have I missed through my life that was important, that I should have saw, but was too busy self-indulging myself and not paying attention to what the past could offer me? That is what history teaches us. Is there something to know from the people who came before us, from their experiences? But in our hubris, we take it for granted and we think, no, my experience is all that matters. What I do is what matters. But your experience can be enhanced by knowing what happened before you, by knowing the mistakes that came before you. You do not have to fall into the same sinkholes as your predecessors. You can be better than that. We all can. And yet, we never look back. Now, It's always about forward thinking, progress. We must have progress for the sake of progress. Maybe we should take a step back. Maybe we should look beyond our immediate future and start looking at a bigger picture and maybe see what the past has to offer us. I'm getting a little preachy, I understand, but it really touched me, this monument, to think about those men, to think about this place at Notre Dame, this esteemed college of higher learning, and yet no one knows. Professors don't know. Historians didn't know. They had to go find it. It just happened that he worked there. And then this was just there. I've never in my life wanted to go to Notre Dame. I had no desire to ever go to this campus. I'm not a fan. But this, to see this, I would go. Maybe read the names on the wall. Know who those men were. I feel for them. I feel for them a lot. There's something to be said about dying for your country in a cause that is bigger than you. And we forget that. We do. It's okay to be individualistic. It is. Selfish even. But we should take time to honor and look back at what the people did before us, because there's something there to it. There's something that can bring us together as one. As a veteran myself, I miss the collective of my unit, my team, my leaders, my subordinates. I miss it. I do. And I find myself now, as an individual, unable to cope like I would be when I was in a team. Because now it's on me, 100%. I can't rely on a team member to pick up any slack that may occur. And that's somewhat a daunting task. To be self-reliant, to try and figure out what to do and have no one to go to. Maybe that's why the suicide rate for veterans is so high. Because we miss the team. We miss the collective. We miss having a set mission in life, or at least being told what a mission was, or where to be, what to do, it's harder to be an individual. But there's also something to be said about being part of a collective, about being part of something bigger than yourself, and the self-sacrifices you make for that cause that may not benefit you. It may not benefit you one bit. It may not benefit you, your family, or the immediate future of your family. But there is the cause, whatever it may be. There's something to be learned from this, and I haven't figured it out yet. But I definitely want to look more into it. And I definitely think we all need to be better. We all need to look at this memory, this monument to death for a cause for so many. It's definitely something. And I hope it makes you think, because it makes me think.